What's up, Sam?
The markets are crashing. What do we do?
No, we are not starting with that yet. What we're starting with is Elevation Asian. Do you know what a Jawser size is? Because I have no idea what it is. I just got on, you know, normal conversation.
We're not starting with that either.
Record.
Nope.
And I'm on here. I'm sitting here. I'm like,
no. No, that's
Sam
private information.
Chewing.
That's private information.
Sam is
that's
chewing
private information, Parker.
This is not.
You would not betray. You would not betray my trust, my friendship, and start the episode talking about that. You wouldn't.
We're not betraying because it's not private information.
It's private information.
It's public now because you were doing it on the podcast recording.
No, I wasn't. You're gonna have to restart. You just ruined the whole thing.
I think you ruined the whole thing because, like, that was a great way to start an episode.
No, it wasn't.
Fitness for your face. Where'd you get this thing, dude? This is great to start a podcast.
I just felt like I was getting a little fat in the face, bro. I just wanted a little.
I feel like we have to
muscle
start the
tone,
episode
bro.
This way.
No, I mean. Elevation Nation, what is up? I'm back from New York, like I never left, back in the district, got to spend some quality time with Parker, with all the guys and gals in New York City. I tried the metaverse for the first time, pretty wild. Check it out if you haven't. It's probably going to take over the world and quite possibly ruin all our lives, but we'll talk about that on a different episode because I think today we're going to get into something that's kind of sweeping the nation today, the past few weeks. I don't know if Parker's freaking out yet, but I know a lot of people are a little apprehensive about what's going on right now. Parker, what are your thoughts, man? How are you?
Well, I'm good. It was nice to see you, and I'm glad you are back safely in your DC apartment with all of your friends and family who are there and your exercise equipment that I'm sure you missed so dearly.
I did.
To keep you fit. Your face fit, your body fit, your jaw fit, everything fit.
Everything's fit, bro. I'm back at it. We got after it at 6:30 this morning. We're back on the daily grind. Feels good.
I'm glad. 6:30 is that's a good time to wake up, right, Elevation Nation? That's a good time to wake up. That's when it's really the elevating time. But yes, I agree. This is a great conversation to have this week because the market has been doing pretty crappy over the past few weeks. So crappy that I think it is the worst market since March 2020. And we all know what happened then. So as a young adult, Sam and I both wanted to talk about our thoughts on it, how we're approaching it, how we're looking at it. And I just wanted to say, as a little disclaimer, in by no way, shape, or form are Sam and I an expert in financial literacy, financial advice, financial in anything, the economy and anything. So this is purely our own opinion. And please do not take any of our advice so seriously that you do something where you lose all your money. But
I think the disclaimer Parker's going for, shout out Benny Kotler, L3 Law School, is the following statements are opinion and not fact. Any actions taken based on these opinions are not subject to implications to HU Media LLC. Or
dude, what are you saying?
The Elevation Nation podcast.
Up in your head. I don't think that's how it goes. I think all we have to say is, these are our opinions. That's it. We're not experts.
No one sue us. We don't have any money for you anyway, so.
Yeah, no money.
Sorry.
Whatever.
All right, let's get into it.
Yeah,
it
all got lost,
man.
In the market, right? No. Well, let's not talk specifically about markets, but as a young adult, you look at your 401k, and you're like, dang, I've been contributing every single month, every week, every paycheck, all this money that I couldn't use to spend on other things in my life. I put it away for 65-year-old me to have. And you look at the market, you're like, dang, I just lost 4% this day, 2% this day, 3% this day. And over time, it's like, dang, that sucks. How do you go about that when you look at that?
Well, I think it's even worse now in today's day and age because you don't have to call up a broker to ask how much money did I lose this week, this month, today, because I get a notification anytime anything swings above or below 5% change. And it's been a lot of swinging negative. And I've been getting a lot of notifications on my phone. And all day today, I was stressing out. I texted my roommate, McP, said, what is going on in the market? And it's scary, especially as a young adult, right? Like, our generation hasn't gone through a big downfall. Like, the pandemic, I don't know if we can count that, what, month that it was bad because it shot up so high right after. Like, it made no sense. But think about, like, our parents' generation, great-grandparents, depression, recession, all this stuff. It's like, we haven't really faced that as contributing members of society. And I think that's a little scary, or people are naive to the fact that, like, things can swing in different directions, and that's kind of normal, unfortunately.
Yeah, I mean, it's not like we're saying that it's a depression or anything right now.
I'm depressed. Because I lost so much money.
Your mind is depressed, but I don't know, the market's got a little correction. But yeah, I mean, it is weird to think about when you look at your phone or whatever and you see whether you're in cryptocurrency, you're in stocks, bonds, mutual funds, ETFs, whatever it is, you look and you're probably not on the green side. If you're on the green side, honestly, you're probably invested in bonds and you're probably a loser. Just kidding. Invest
Again,
in bonds.
Opinions only.
I mean, as a 26-year-old, you shouldn't be invested in bonds. You're not 66 years old. So what I'm saying is it's all relative, right, Sam? I mean, when you look at that type of stuff, I think young adults love to play the market. I mean, we have friends. I know people who, like, literally look every day. They play, they buy, they sell, they day trade. And those people are either making a lot of money or they're losing a lot of money. It's like gambling. It's like walking into a casino, putting it on the table, and you have a 50% chance of winning or a 50% chance of losing. I mean, look at cryptocurrency, people shelling out all this money, and like some of these cryptocurrencies are going to literally zero. That's gambling. I think the way I look and approach the stock market is I contribute every single week, no matter if it's a dollar, no matter if it's $20, $50, I always like to contribute every week, regardless of if the market is up or it's down, because I'm in it for the long game. And I know I'm not a loser unless I sell. When I sell, I'm a loser or a winner. But in this market, if I sold, because things are going down, I'm scared, I'm fearful, and I want to rearrange my investment, then I'm a loser. Once you sell, you become a loser. It's changing your mindset around the fact that I'm in it for so long, dude. This thing's going to swing up and down and everything around. But there's one thing consistent, and it's that 8%, Sam, that we're trying to go for every single year. And if you can grab that 8% every year, then that's growth.
Yeah, no, I think you're absolutely right.
Over a long period of time.
I think a lot of young people look at the market and think when it swings down or up, that makes or breaks their financial situation. If you're smart, you're not relying on the income you make from your stocks to pay for your life, your everyday life. And if you're even more smart, like Parker said, and you're not a, to quote Parker here, a loser, you're not selling all the time, right? So your reliance on that stock market in the short term being up or down should not necessarily be there. But I do think it brings up an interesting point and something I've been thinking about a lot the past few weeks, which is, I'm going to call them get rich relatively quick schemes because I'm not sure what else to call them right now. But there are a lot of alternative ways that are blowing up on the internet right now on how to make money quickly. And people are saying, oh, I'm a 14-year-old, I did it. I'm a 16-year-old, I did it. And as a grown adult with a job, investing in the stock market, dealing with the highs and lows, I've been questioning myself. Have I been putting my money in the right place? Am I thinking too old school with how I'm approaching finances? We're in a totally different generation. Should I be investing in the stock market? Should I be investing in the metaverse and NFTs and blockchain and crypto and real estate and other places. And it's a scary and overwhelming question. Again, Parker and I don't have the answers. We're still trying to figure it out ourselves. It's not like I'm rich or anything, but
I don't think anybody has the answers, to be honest with you, because they'd be a genius. And maybe some of the wealthiest people in the world are geniuses and have the answers, but most people don't have the answers.
Yeah. And I think this stock market example and talking about finances right now hits on a nerve that Parker and I love to talk about that's not so great for Gen Z and millennials and pretty much all of Elevation Nation, which is we want that instant gratification. And that's been embedded in us through technology, through social media. And guess what? That instant gratification of making a ton of money on the stock market, maybe once in a while you'll hit it out of the park. I've had a couple of those so far in my trading career. Most of the time, it's pretty steady and boring, right? And so that's sometimes tough for people to not have that instant gratification, to be rewarded for their patience, their investment. They want to get rich. Well, those things take time. And so remember, it's a long game, like Parker said. Don't be a loser. I like that quote, Parker.
Yeah, no, seriously, you're only a loser if you sell. That's my mental motto of the week or whatever. But
unless
I think
you gain.
One thing that I've learned and I've really tried to embed in the way I go about my personal finances is when moments like this happen, you see the stock market, you know, another day in the red, another day in the red, another day in the red. And it comes out to the Friday when I look at my bank account and I'm like, all right, what money am I putting in this week? Because I'm able to, thankfully, you know, don't have to pay off certain bills and whatnot. It's battle testing my process, my system, and the way I go about my personal finances. And regardless if the market goes up like crazy or goes down like crazy, I believe that if I continue to put money in every week in the long game, I'll be up. So it is hard when you see the market going down. You're like, dang, it went down this week. It went down next week. And I keep putting more money in. But I have a system in place that I believe in. And it is a routine that I have, and to have, let's say, mental fortitude to continue with that routine is so important. Your routine, Sam, is different than mine. The way your personal finance routine is different, but consistency is so key, I think, when it comes to personal finances. And I found that to be a really big thing. In the way I've gone about it since I've graduated college, consistency is so key.
Yeah. And I think the more and more we bake in these habits into our everyday lives, we come up with a system that works for us, the more confident we feel when things swing and go in different directions. So it alleviates some of that stress and anxiety, at least on myself. So again, Parker and I are not financial experts. We are still trying to figure out ways to make money, to make passive income, to grow our net worth. But don't freak out if you're freaking out with the market right now. Things ebb and flow. Just try to be strategic, try to be smart, and most importantly, be patient and consistent, and you will reap the benefits in the long run when you want to be playing golf and sitting on a beach vibing.
Well, that's your, you know, maybe people want to like be
travel the world,
the drums,
play pickleball. I want to play pickleball when I'm older. It's my dream.
I don't know. Maybe they want to start their own bar or something. I don't know. Could be give back to the society, donate their money. I don't know. Everyone's got their own thing.
You don't know? Or do you know?
Well,
you know,
quick Parker's perspective. And I really like when Parker's perspective just it doesn't relate anything to the topic.
You do. I hate that.
Oh, I mean, like, it's fine.
I'm just kidding.
I mean,
Go ahead.
This one's by Neil deGrasse Tyson. I just came across it this week. I'm just like,
he's a
quote. And he said, "The universe is under no obligation to make sense to you. The stock market is under no obligation to make sense to you. Everything that happens in a given day probably is in no obligation to make sense to you. Or moral contracts or human contracts make sense to us, but at the end of the day, the world will keep spinning and doing crazy things. So just be yourself in terms of being consistent, with the way that you approach life, the way you go about your routines, the way you've instilled your habits. And that's all we can do. That's all we can do. Just be consistent and be ourselves.
And with that, Elevation Nation, check out our episode this week with Miles Robertson, all about positivity. He's honestly one of the most positive people I've ever met. You will get a smile on your face and feel inspired to live a more positive life. So check it out. And until next week, peace.